So for us to be able to talk about generalization, it helps to think about states as actually being collections of features instead of just unanalyzed blobs.
Mm. So we're no longer going to refer to states as state 17 and state 19?
We can, but I think it's helpful actually to give them additional information like these features. So here's a concrete example to make this try to make some sense. Do you remember our taxi problem that we talked about before?
How could I forget?
In this particular environment, there was something like, I don't know, 500 states. And in standard Q-learning type approaches, we would just think of all those different states as being completely different from one another. But we can also imagine tagging each of the states with some particular value, like whether or not we didn't really have fuel when we talked about it, but whether we're low on fuel, what is the x-coordinate of the taxi cab, this thing here? What's the y-coordinate of the taxi cab? Is the taxi cab currently near a wall, say to the, you know, to some direction, north, south, east, west? Each of these different features give us a little bit of a handle on the states and how they relate to each other, right? So if we have this state that we've got right here and we say move the passenger to some other position, we're still in a related state. You know, the taxi hasn't moved, and it would be nice to be able to capture that. And so this notion of features gives us that idea. Does that make sense?
So that's a lot like how we talked about machine learning and supervised learning in our other machine learning class.
Exactly. Oh, yeah. Oh, in fact, wait, we had words for these things. We talked about what were those words? The sort of the notion that different machine learning representations cause different things to be similar to each other.
Right. And there are lots of different ways that we could represent this state space other than whatever the different 500 states are. You have some of them up here, but we could have the coordinates of where the passenger is, not just the coordinates of where the taxi is. We could have things represented in sort of an egocentric way of what's the, I don't know, Manhattan distance between a passenger and where the passenger wants to end up. There are all kinds of things that the ways we could describe things, and some of those things make some states look more similar than other representations would.
I think I remembered the term. I think it was inductive bias.
Inductive bias was something that referred to the way algorithms preferred one solution over another.
Oh.
But I think you're right, though, because different features sort of create different kind of inductive biases by making some states look more similar. So, for example, if we had this egocentric notion of how far away a person is from a taxi, then so long as a person is, say, two steps away from the taxi, any state where a person is two steps away from a taxi looks the same, or it looks very similar.
Mm.
In fact, if you look at this one you have now, she just drew that, right? The red circle is close to the orange square. If you were to move both the red circle and the orange square up, those two states would still be very similar because they're still two away from one another, or have two in between them. But even though I don't move the red circle, if I take the orange square and move it to the right, then that's less similar because they're farther apart.
Hmm. Okay, and though we're ignoring walls the way that you described that, right?
Right, I'm ignoring walls.
We move both of these up by two. We're two apart, but it does feel kind of different because we don't have to go around the walls.
And if it's different or not different depends upon the state features that you use.
Okay, do we have a name for that, or is inductive bias an okay stand-in?
It's a representation, right? It's a representation issue. Some representations are better for some things than others, and you can learn differently depending upon what features you choose.
Okay.
For example, here's a great feature. For every state, here's the set of actions you should take to accomplish the goal. That's one representation that makes learning really easy.
Ah, yes, good point. So let's talk about what we're actually going to learn.
Okay.